Hello guys, and welcome back to A Sale by Sketchbook. I don't know if you knew this about me, but I used to be a teaching assistant in Ajman University of Science and Technology. I made this presentation back in the day because I got asked about it all the time. So I decided to make a presentation that might help people, you know, get what a concept in interior design is. And this is the exact same presentation that I gave to my students how many years ago? Like 4 years ago. So what we started with, I started distributing oranges among the students, and you know, some of them ate it, some of them like played around with it, opened it up. For the b-roll, I couldn't find any oranges in my fridge, but I found a grapefruit, which is orange's cousin. And what I requested from them is to write down everything that they see within this orange, in your presentation, the color, basically an analysis of that orange in keywords. So it could be that the orange is layered, it could be that it had veins, it could have been that it has pores on the skin, and then you can peel the skin and there's connections inside. It's all about making them analyze objects around them, whether it's in an aesthetic way or in a functional way. It's all about analyzing. So what I asked them next to do is to read three of their main keywords out loud. And it was interesting because they chose things that I didn't expect. Some said citrus, some said warm. There were very interesting keywords to the whole thing, which was very fun to listen to. So let's talk about what an interior design concept means. It's to look beyond the flooring and the paint and all of these elements that create a space. It's to look at the message that a space tries to convey to you. The most successful designers are the ones that have a concept behind their design. Even if you can't see it, most designers create concepts before they design a space. Now, because the idea is still vague, let's look at example. The three different types of concepts can be social, aesthetic, or psychological concepts. The fourth type is a mix of all three or two of them. So what do I mean by a social concept? Social concept, when you get inspired by social connection and linking an idea to a foundation of a keyword. For example, if we look at an orange, the central column of the orange is the main connection that distributes nutrients to all of the different parts of the orange. Also, if we look at an ant colony, we're gonna see very interesting shapes and forms. It's all built around functionality and circulation on how the ants function together. So they make it easier to reach the goal. And the way you can apply such a concept is by creating circulation that mimics that very same inspiration, which is the ant's colony. And also, if you look at the shape, it's such an organic shape. And these little nooks where they store things is very interesting, and how they circulate within it. Now, if you think about the aesthetics, most of the interior designers, they use aesthetic as their main foundation for building a concept for their projects. It's to observe the beauty of a shape or anything that inspires them. But basically, they take a shape that they like, they abstract it, use the form, which always should follow the function, to emphasize the lines of the shape, and can be used pretty much anywhere, whether it's in walls, whether it's in, again, building the space planning, or it can be basically used in any kind of detail. Third type of concepts is psychological, and also it's widely used because it affects how people interact within the space. It's basically the study on how potential shape or form could affect people psychologically, how it affects the human behavior and feelings, like color psychology, shape psychology, and arrangement. My example was a circle. Now, if you create your design around a circle, let's say something as of a feature, or in a social situation, if you have a circular sofa and people are sitting here, it includes inclusion, wholeness, focus, unity. And this is like the meaning of thinking deeper than just colors and materials and furniture. It's basically you are studying how people will feel within a space. Of course, you can mix between the three types of concepts, and this is like such a deep level of, you know, interior design. Okay, so we talked about the types of concepts. How do we formulate one? We can have a brainstorm session, we can get inspired from something, or we can do psychological linking. So let's start with brainstorming. And the way I brainstorm, and I encourage you to brainstorm as well, is to have a main word where all of the other words are linking to this main word. And you do not have to polish your thoughts for this. Actually, the more rough, the better. Let me put book, the word book, in the middle of the page as example. I can extract the word pages. I can extract magic. I can also say white, font, letter. I can say cover. And I can take one of these words and create my design around it. And this is how you gain a concept. The other way to get inspired is by mood boards and sketches. And I have enough videos to link them down below. If you take that effort to make a mood board for your concept, that way you can actually, you know, have a creative direction in general. You can as well sketch as a brainstorm on your, you know, possible concepts. I love the way Kareem Rashid always have a really nice concept. Your concept should be abstracted, so simplify it as much as you can. Make sure that it's clear to you and it should be useful to people. What are you giving the people that you're designing for out of your concept? Things to remember when applying your concept is that form should follow function. And less is more. So do not make it too obvious that your main concept is, for example, a boat. Be subtle about it. The more subtle you are, the harder it is to, you know, notice the concept, the better it is. Or in Kareem Rashid sort of way, go all out. I also talked about adding the flavor of the to your concept, and that is style. We'll talk more about style categories and characteristics in next videos. Thank you so much, guys, for watching, and have a great time of the day wherever you are in the world. Goodbye.